In this section, we quickly discuss a hybrid concept where the junction consists of both inorganic and organic compounds. This concept is the so-called dye-sensitized solar cell. The dye-sensitized solar cell is often abbreviated as DSSC. The learning objectives are to recognize and understand the typical architecture of a dye-sensitized solar cell and the photovoltaic and electrochemical mechanisms involved. Furthermore, we will quickly review the pros and cons of dye-sensitized solar cells in reference to other PV technologies. The conventional dye-sensitized solar cell is a photoelectrochemical system. It contains of titanium oxide nanoparticles, dye particles, an electrolyte, and a transparent front electrode and a platinum back contact. In this illustration, the dye-sensitized solar cell is schematically shown. Let's consider first the photoactive parts of the solar cell. These parts consist of the photoactive dye sensitizer, which acts like an electron donor, and secondly, the nanoparticles, which act like the electron acceptor. Similar to organic bulk material in a heterojunction solar cell, the dye material is mixed with titanium oxide particles. The photoactive material is the so-called dye photosensitizer, ruthenium polypyridine. The operation is illustrated in the following animation. If a photon is absorbed by the ruthenium polypyridine, it can excite an electron from its ground state, referred to as S, to an excited state, referred to as SX'. The light-excited electrons are injected into the titanium oxide nanoparticles. The photosensitizer molecule remains like a positively charged entity. The electrons in the titanium oxide move to the TCO-based contact. The mechanism of this electron transport is based on diffusion. The electrons diffuse between the various titanium oxide nanoparticles until they arrive at the TCO front contact. Via the electric circuit, the electrons move to the front contact. The back contact is electrically connected to the dye via an electrolyte. Electrolytes are solutions or compounds that contain ionized entities that can conduct electricity. The typical electrolyte that is used in conventional dye-sensitized solar cells is iodine. The positively charged oxidized dye molecule is neutralized by a negatively charged iodide. Three negatively charged iodides neutralize two dye molecules and create one negatively charged triiodide. This negatively charged triiodide moves through the electrolyte to the counter electrode, where it reduces using two electrons into three negatively charged iodine. Let's look at these mechanisms one more time, but then illustrated in an energy band diagram. If a photon is absorbed by the ruthenium polypyridine, it can excite an electron from its ground state, referred to as S, to an excited state, referred to as S'. In this case, the S can be considered as the HOMO and the S' state can be considered as the LUMO. The S' state has a higher energy level than the energy level of the conduction band of the titanium oxide. As a result, the light-excited electrons are injected into the titanium oxide nanoparticles. Note that the photosensitizer molecule remains like a positively charged entity. The electrons in the titanium oxide move to the TCO-based front contact. The mechanism of this electron transport is based on diffusion. The electrons diffuse between the various titanium oxide nanoparticles until they arrive at the TCO contact. Now, for example, a second photon excites an additional dye molecule. Another electron is injected in the titanium oxide nanoparticles, and via the electric circuit, the electrons move to the front TCO to the back contact. Between the counter electrode and the dye iodine, an electrolyte is present. Negatively charged triiodide moves through the electrolyte to the counter electrode, where it is reduced. Two electrons are used to reduce triiodide into three negatively charged iodide ions. When people talk about electrochemical systems, the terms oxidation and reduction are often used. Oxidation means that the chemical species, which can be an atom, molecule, or ion, loses an electron in the reaction. Reduction is the opposite. When an electron is added to the chemical species, the reaction is called reduction. So by adding the electrons to a single negatively charged triiodide, at the front electrode, three negatively charged iodines are formed. We are adding electrons, so this is called reduction. The negatively charged iodide ions move through the electrode to the dye particles. The positively charged oxidized dye molecules are neutralized by the negatively charged iodides. Three negatively charged iodides neutralize two dye molecules and create one negatively charged triiodide. The electrons are stripped from the iodides. Therefore, this is called an oxidation reaction. To facilitate the redox reaction, these photoelectrochemical cells require a platinum back contact. As a result, the performance of a dye-sensitized solar cell depends on the HOMO and the LUMO level of the dye material, the Fermi level of the titanium oxide nanoparticles, and the so-called redox potential of the iodide and triiodide reactions. The current certified record efficiency of dye-sensitized PV device on lab scale is 11.9% and was achieved by Sharp in 2011. The advantage of dye-sensitized PV devices are the low-cost price of producing the device. The disadvantage is the stability of the electrolyte under various weather conditions. At low temperature, the electrolyte can freeze. This stops the power production and it might result in physical damage of the cell. Higher temperatures result in thermal expansion of the electrolyte, which make encapsulation of the modules more complicated. The dye-sensitized PV technology is facing some more challenges. Therefore, replacing the expensive platina electrode material with other cheaper materials is a topic of ongoing research. The second one is the development of more stable and resistive electrolyte materials. The third one is the development of improved dyes, improving the spectral and band gap utilization of the solar cells. In summary, the conventional dye-sensitized solar cell is a photoelectrochemical system. It contains titanium oxide nanoparticles, dye particles, an electrolyte and a transparent front electrode and a platinum back contact. In this illustration, the dye-sensitized solar cell is schematically shown. As yet, no dye-sensitized PV products are commercially available. Many people working in the field of dye-sensitized solar cells have moved their research activities to perovskite solar cells. We will discuss this new emerging PV technology in the next video lectures.